got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when you're coming to take your freedoms away.
And protesters opposed to mountaintop removal coal mining shut down operations at a controversial West Virginia strip mine over the weekend with a series of coordinated lockdowns, tree sits, and banner drops. Police said about 20 activists were arrested after the action Saturday at Patriot Coal's Hobbit strip mine in Lincoln County, West Virginia, most of them charged with trespassing. Activists with the group RAPS, a Radical Action for Mountain People Survival, criticized the Obama administration's regulatory policies and said mining practices are endangering the health and safety of people in Appalachia.
Well, that was a great report, Amy, but I don't think you told the people quite enough about that situation. Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. I became aware of what you just saw on Democracy Now! Because of this credo alert. The 20 people that were arrested, $25,000 bail each, okay? Little comparison here, where it states that if you beat up your girlfriend or your wife, you would only have to pay a $2,500 bond. I remember reading that. That information is in here. I want to point it out to you right here. To put the $25,000 bail in context, West Virginia men arrested for physically assaulting their wives and girlfriends are frequently released on bail as of little as $2,500 to $5,000. Just a fraction. Now, these people were protesting, nonviolent protesters, to stop a company that likes to cut the tops of mountains off. Okay, but there's more to it. Okay, not only were these 20 people arrested, but you'll see here, to make matters worse, we've heard disturbing reports of possible police misconduct. One of the local activists has accused police of beating him while in custody. In addition to those reports, there are reasons to believe the protesters were mistreated, including reports that one woman was dragged off the coal company's property by her pigtails. Shuttles that were prepared to pick up the supporters of the protest who didn't get arrested were blocked from accessing the area by police, forcing about 30 protesters to walk 15 miles, 4 hours, through a gauntlet of coal industry supporters who taunted and intimidated them. And so if we're 15 miles outside of town, well secluded, we can assume that the allegations of the police brutality were very reasonable, okay? That they probably did do something that they should not have done because they weren't being watched by anybody other than advocates for the coal industry. Okay, so that's one thing. Other information you should have. The company, Patriot Coal, by the way, is filing for Chapter 11. What is Chapter 11? It's when you can't pay your debtors, your creditors, and you go into reorganization. But this isn't always, I'm going to link you to this. I already read it once. If you don't believe me, you get off your ass and go click the links and read, okay? This isn't doesn't mean that all things will be settled. This is also a way that a company can liquidate itself. Hail the corporation. We love it. Okay? This is from their FAQ page, Patriot Coal FAQ page. Chapter 11 cases typically last from 9 to 24 months. They can last for years. They do say sometimes longer, but the assumption is made in months. So you would assume a few more months, but actually years is more reasonable. And they can't guarantee any change to their stock, which you can get the stock information here as well. All kinds of information about this company, their annual reports, if you want to dig into that. But now, back to the petition. Obviously, I'm going to sign it. Okay? Not that I ultimately think that this does any good at all, because, again, you're yelling at the people that are fucking you over, so you're petitioning them to stop fucking you. And that's, but we got to start somewhere, right? So, and I'd like to do more than this. I'd like to point out that the state attorney's office for the Southern District of West Virginia has three different fax numbers. Okay, 1, 2, 3. I mean, you could call them, give them your opinion, or you could fax them. In fact, you could fax them repeatedly for free. Yeah, you could do that. The links to do that will be below. Information, etc., etc. Now, if you don't know anything about the coal industry, yes, we need power, and that's part of the problem. It goes back to me always saying, you won't give up anything. And people, 20 people were arrested, 30 others made, so maybe there were 50, 60 people there protesting. 50 or 60 people actually give a fuck that our mountaintops are being cut off. That's what they do here at Patriot Coal. They go cut the tops of mountains off and get the coal out of it. And their about page has been removed. Isn't that something? Wow. Well, that's maybe just a glitch. Anyway, that's what they do. They rip down our mountaintops. Only about 60 people give a fuck. Half of them were arrested for high bail. And this is the place to fax if you don't like that idea. And this is the place to get the free fax if you don't have a fax. So you don't need a fax. So you can just click any of these links and input this information and maybe do that through a proxy and then do it repeatedly. Share it with your friends. Anyway, much love. Many thanks to the 60 that give a fuck.